peace. I will cherish this letter. You know why? When she becomes a saint, when she is canonized saint, I have something really, really significant that I can show, display. It's still taken. It's in my name, but it's okay. It is to be treated with absolute care. Imagine those who are friends to Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa has signed some letters.
It's not open yet.
Imagine those. Now that she's a saint, look, this is just the handwriting of the saint. Same thing with that. To me, she's already a saint. And there are also three other saints here.
In the making.
I don't know about Anthony, but we will find out.
Saint Anthony.
Yeah. Why did I underline this? That's how we began. Remember, I began by saying, nobody knows but the Father, right? Only the Father knows. That's what's in the Bible. And we said, it's impossible for Jesus not to know it. The Father and Jesus are one and the same. It's just that what it means is, it's not the role of the Messiah to proclaim the end. The role of the Messiah is to save, to redeem, not to proclaim the end. Who started the world? The Father. Remember, the Father is the creator. Because the Father is the creator, only the Father knows and should say when the end will be. Are you ready when he comes for us? Are you? Is that done? Sunday is the first Sunday of Advent.
Yes.
You know that? Even the liturgy of the hours is changing volume next Sunday. We're switching, we're not ordinary time anymore. So the question is, are you ready? When he comes? Remember, nobody knows. He's coming. Well, we will celebrate December 25. He's coming. He's to be born. But it's just a celebration. It's still Black Friday, if it matters to you. after December 3. You know Black Friday? You don't know Black Friday?
Yes.
So make me pray sacramental confessions. You know what is good about confession? One very good thing about confession is you become humble. You're humbled by it, aren't you? Imagine a sinner, a priest who is a sinner too, you will confide all your sins. That's humbling. And that humbling experience alone is good enough reason for confession. The good thing about talking to a live priest, confessing, as opposed to confessing to God directly, can we confess to God directly? Certainly. The problem is, what does God say? What does God say? The problem there is humility issue. It's so difficult to be humble when you always talk to God alone. It doesn't show. Because God says you must love God above all and love your neighbor as well. You can't just, you and God, and forget about everybody else. The Catechism says you cannot love God if you ignore your neighbor. Nor can you love your neighbor ignoring God. You can't. There has to be both. Which brings us to the sacramental confession. It's the humility issue here. This is a humbling. It makes you humble when you confess. Here's another key word here. Worthy. Humility, devotion. You must worthily receive communion in humility and devotion. And what about number 5? Faithfully minister in body and spirit to those in need. Two things. Body and spirit. What does that mean? Whatever help you do, whatever thing you do, you must do it out of love. If you have a different motive for doing something good, it doesn't count. You know that, right? It doesn't count. Like those politicians who go to soup kitchen. And then there's a camera following. There's a camera, and then they show it on TV. See? He's helping the soup kitchen. Is that out of love?
No.
It doesn't seem like it is. Because if it's really out of love, you don't need camera. You know that? You must do it out of love. That's the meaning of in body and in spirit. You're helping all right in body, but what about spirit? No. Therefore, useless. No point. And these two words, justice, mercy. What about justice and mercy? Jesus says, I don't want suffering. I don't want sacrifice. I want mercy. Book of Mark. If you get your materials,
he should drive again.
He became cold. Weekly Bible study class notes. But I have a line for you. So you're a king. Pontius Pilate says, so you're a king. Jesus says, yes, you say I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world. Highlight, to testify to the truth. And everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice. You see it? I am a weekly Bible study class. It's the day-by-day thing. Number one, asking my own questions. I will be judged one day on how I judge. What is your opinion based on? Is it based on what others have said, or based on what you know? In the end, we will be judged on how we judge. Okay? So if we judge others, then we will be judged likewise. Number two, it's a world where people, once accused, are already judged. Where most judgments remain hidden, but still assassinate the person through actions and omissions. What others think of you? This is similar to what I've said many months ago. We are so concerned about what people think. I beg you, you should have less of that. Less of what people think. It should be more of what God thinks. Who cares what people think? It will not kill you. You should worry about what God thinks. Three, belonging to the kingdom of truth. I like this dictatorship of relativism. That should be highlighted. Dictatorship of relativism. You know what it means? Oh, that's your truth. I have my own truth. Relativism. And it's killing our society. Why do you think we have so many churches all over the place? Because of relativism. That's your truth. I have my own truth, so I put my own church. But there's only one truth. That's a problem. There's only one truth. There's only one Holy Spirit. How come we have thousands of denominations? Monday, Luke 21, the richest gift. Remember the poor widow? Put in more than all the rest. Those others from their surplus. From her poverty, she offered her whole livelihood. So she gave more. Anyone here was worried? Are you worried? Anyone worried now? You're not worried. A poor widow. She gave more because she gave herself with a heart full of surrender. With a heart full of surrender, that should be highlighted. Then this question. Is there anything we can give God that He has not already given us? Remember last time we met, there was a question posed by Peter. I'm getting tired of this giving. We always give and give and give. When do we stop giving? Am Remember the response of God, Jesus?
When I stop giving
you. You only stop giving when I stop giving to you. What about forgiving? Those idiots never learn. And you want me to continue forgiving? You only stop forgiving when God stops forgiving you. Because all of us are fallen short, very short, in the sight and eyes of God. Book of Romans. November 27, why so glum? Luke 21. Many will come in my name, saying, I am he. And the time has come, do not follow them. December 21 is now the date of the end of the world, they say again. Don't believe that. You would have seen Bangabi, December 20-something. After the end of the world. Temple of Doom. The end of the temple will not be the end of religion. Remember in 70 AD, the Romans have actually toppled down the temple. They really destroyed it all. The only thing that remained was the Western Wall. And that's still there to this day. That's where the Jews would pray. Remember they do this? I don't want to do it because I can get dizzy. Jesus himself will remain with us. Remember the meditation? I am with you always. As he does to this day in the Eucharist, no matter what else passes away, our house, our office, our school, Christ remains. Is that clear? All of these will pass away, all of this. That's why there's a saying, the greatest problem to solve is time. You agree? Time is one very great problem solver. Somebody dies, so you cry. Don't tell me you cry for 20, 30, 40 years, 40 years. Few days, and then it would be gone. Then you get used to it. Time has solved the problem. Be not deceived, number two. Focus on what's really important, the faith. Our Lord wants them not to listen to the wrong people.